Here we have an NVIDIA RTX 4080 Founders Edition that came in for repair. We have the board right here, and the customer is paying for expedited service, so we can do it for him as soon as possible. Right off the bat, I see what looks like a broken connector right here. Right off the bat. I did not read what the customer wrote, but we see a broken connector. We worked on a similar card on the 4090 about a month ago, and we were wondering how that connector broke off. The card came in with exactly the same problem. The whole connector is broken off, and all the pins are stuck inside. We said, who broke this? Godzilla? King Kong? Because even if you try to break that connector with your hand, it's not possible. Look at this. Look at this. Every single pin is broken inside the holes. That's a common defect with 40 series graphics cards. The connector breaks right off. What is that connector made out of? Biscuit? It's broken off, and it looks like the customer attempted to do some soldering here. We see signs of flux. A solder blob here, a solder blob here. And he attempted to work on this one maybe, and he did not realize how much heat that board takes before you can solder anything onto that board. Let's read what the customer wrote. The customer said, contacted about 4080 Founders, would like to send it in for service. 4080 connector broke from pressure on side panel. Would like the adapter cables cut, stripped, and then soldered directly to the board versus a new connector. I'm afraid that's not going to be possible. That's not a practical job to work on. We cannot just cut, strip, and solder the wires onto the rings. The rings are going to break off. And if we are to put the wires through the holes and solder from the back, that's not going to be possible also. The wires are thick. Unless I want to spend the whole day working on soldering those wires, trying to figure out where each wire goes. We have how many? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 wires we have to solder on the board. We have to figure out where each wire goes. And we have to squeeze that wire inside the hole. That wire may not go in. We have to cut the wire. That's not a practical repair, and we do not do that right here. What we're going to do is solder a connector. If that cable was plugged in properly without forcing that connector, you should not have any issues. If the cable is short, maybe you should buy a bigger cable and connect it in a way where there is not a lot of pressure onto that connector. It looks like those connectors are weak to begin with. That's why they are breaking like this. Or maybe the board is suffering a lot of heat from this area, making the metal fragile, and that's why the connector is breaking. Whatever the case may be, that's a factory defect. I call this a factory defect, and I heard a lot about the 40 series graphics cards where connectors are melting or they have issues. Even if we solder the wire on to the ring here or through hole, if this area is suffering a lot of heat, solder will melt. We're gonna have issues again. The proper way to do this right now would be to solder a new connector, and that's what we're gonna be doing. We're not gonna reinvent the wheel and create modifications, impractical modifications that will take us all day to do. That's not a practical repair. I do not know if it's even possible to fit the wire inside the hole. I never stripped one of those wires before, but the wire is thick. I mean, this is a braided wire here, but even if we remove that braid, I doubt that we're going to be able to fit the wires inside the hole. So we're not going to do it. We're going to solder a new connector, and we'll let the customer know. Customers are not micro-soldering experts, so they think they know what they're talking about, or they think they can enforce an idea, but it's not practical. Is it doable? Of course it's doable. If we want to fiddle with the wires, make the wire thinner so it can fit inside, it may be possible, but it's impractical. Now the board is going to take a lot of heat before we will be able to melt unleaded solder in the holes. A lot of heat. Look up the 480 I did maybe about a month ago. A lot of work just to desolder and remove the broken pins from the holes. And the reason is because of the thermal mass. I'm applying 450 degrees Celsius. I'm close to the board, and the board is laughing at me. The board is saying, what are you doing? Look at this. 450 degrees Celsius. That's pin one. Now the board reached melting temperature of solder, so we can easily remove those pins, just like that. Anything here? That pin want to play games. We got it. And I have my metal board holder right under the board so we do not burn the mat. Like I did when I was in the old location. My mat was all brown and black. Okay, awesome. So we removed all the broken pins. And I have them on my bench here. I'm gonna clean up later. But for now, we're gonna apply low melt solder so we can easily wick off and desolder the holes. We're gonna do that using a big chisel tip for maximum heat transfer and with the help of hot air, a combination, because we are working with a monster. You cannot scare a monster with a slingshot. You have to have a machine gun. Now YouTube is gonna read the captions, machine gun in the video, and bad things will happen. Let's get rid of the glare. And we're gonna apply low melt solder. A tiny bit of low melt solder goes a long way. On this board, applying low melt solder like this is not enough. We have to apply hot air so low melt sinks inside the hole. The board is thick. How many layers? 14 layers, 12 layers? I do not know. And I see a resistor that may have came off on the left side. How did that happen? Was that like that before? It looks like it's obvious the resistor came off from right here. Maybe it was like that before. Look at how much heat it takes to solder one tiny component. Very nice. Check the area again, make sure everything is good. Now we're gonna have to apply hot air on those joints because we want low melt to sink along with some flux. Low melt, as you can see, melts at a very low temperature. But we want it to mix with unleaded that's inside the holes. Just like that, you see? What we can do is we can apply low melt from the back also. If low melt did not sink all the way to the back, we can do it from the back. And it looks like low melt did sink all the way to the back. It does not hurt to go at it one more time from the back. That way our job becomes a lot easier. Spend a little time now and less time later. Oh, look at this, we still have a broken pin right here. Look at the quality of this microscope. Look at the details. I keep mentioning the NorthridgeFix microscope is one of the best quality microscopes out there. Just compare. You will know it's our microscope when you turn it on. You will be greeted with the NorthridgeFix logo. And it's edge-to-edge sharpness. You see some microscopes where they are blurry on the corners and sharp in the center. But ours is edge-to-edge sharpness. Right now I have the anti-glare light on. And you cannot even see the glare on the flux. I want to show you if I put the anti-glare light off. Look at this. That's how content creators work on YouTube. Glare like this. We are special. We have the anti-glare light. Look at this. Just watch this video on a big screen TV and enjoy. Only for you. And the area is dry, we need to add more flux. That's what happens when the area is dry. We need to add more flux, and we possibly have to desolder from the back and from the front. Sometimes the hole may appear like it still has solder, but it could be flux. And we have a new, brand new connector here. Wow, the fit is perfect. Look at this. The fit is perfect. The connector is flush. We're gonna solder it from the back here. And perfect. So I'm pressing down on the board over the connector so everything is nice and flush. And we're gonna solder a couple of pins first so we can hold that connector in place. And then I'll let go and solder the rest of the pins. Just secure the connector. We do not even have flux here. So I just applied a river of flux because we need it. We should be able to solder all the pins now. Why are you applying so much flux? I don't know. Are you paying for the flux? The more flux you have, the better the joints are. One thing you will learn when you start soldering is you can never have enough flux. We are dealing with a microscopic area, so it looks like a lot under the microscope, but we are using a tiny bit. If we want to do a good job for the customer, we need to use a lot of flux. That's a fact. Here's some more for you. So we have more than enough solder on those pins. And finally, we're gonna clean up. We're gonna apply a fresh layer of flux and go at this one more time. We do not need to apply solder again. We'll just go over the ones that we have on the board. And we're gonna go like 1, 2, 3, 4. Why 4 and not 5? It doesn't matter. Need more flux on the bottom. Wow, beautiful. Let's take a look at the front, and we can see how solder went all the way up. Look at the joints. Solder is not only from the bottom, but it made its way all the way up. Right here, you can see solder right here, right here, right here, and all the pins on the back. Beautiful. That connector is more solid than factory. Better than factory, always. Why assemble components at the factory when you can do it here? Better than factory, right? And that board is clean. Cleaner than factory. Wow, and look at the connector. You cannot even tell that we've been here. Fume extractor off. And we're gonna plug the power cable in. Right here. And all we have to do is try it. So I connected two cables, and we need to connect the third one. One, two, and three. And all three are connecting to that connector that we just soldered. We have the HDMI cable plugged in. And we're gonna turn the power supply on. Okay, and we should see an image on the top screen. Right there, you see it? Right here. We're done. The video card is working. Disconnect the cables, one and two and three. We're gonna disconnect the HDMI cable, already disconnected. We're gonna invoice and mail this back to the customer. Again, the connector is right there. We did an amazing job. We're gonna keep the cable connected to the video card like this. The customer has to be careful, of course, because we do not know how those connectors are breaking. We did an amazing job on the soldering, so I do not see how that connector can possibly break. We're gonna let the customer know what we did. We're gonna invoice and mail this back to the customer. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think. Leave it down in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll do something else in the next video.